let's play some hockey. And as always, we like to thank our servicemen and women around the world protecting our freedoms here at home. Thank you for your service. This morning's starting goaltenders brought to you by the Spine and Joint Institute. Visit them at sjinstitute.com for your chiropractic and joint needs. And book your appointment with Dr. Felix Yeskin and Dr. Maria Schaefer. Shrems, who do we have starting in goal this morning?
We give Lucas Thurston a well-deserved day off. They're going to put Sean Davis in net. Certainly no slouch himself. 12-2 on the season. One shutout with a 2-1-2 goals against average. Not too shabby. On the other end, Patrick Anderson getting the start. A 2-11 record with a 6-6 goals against average and an 8-1-7 save percentage.
Those are your Spine and Joint Institute starting goaltenders. Visit sjinstitute.com today. We have referee talking with Dr. Felix Yeskin himself, the owner of the Spine and Joint Institute. But now we'll get the opening faceoff. One back by the Knights to Gibson. Along the near side, over to Stallard. Stallard chipping it into the Patriots zone, but swept away by Riley Winnett. Over to Micah DeBow. DeBow clearing it in, back behind the goal. That is Davis in net, as Brian had just indicated. Barber with it in the near corner with a drop pass behind the back over to Parker. Judd Parker trying to work his way through traffic, but in the way of that was Harley. Harley, yesterday, was tossed for checking from behind. And the remainder of the game, he was given a disqualification. So he's back in the lineup for the Knights this morning. Reynolds back in the far corner of his own zone with a cross-ice feed over to the near side. Wrangled down by Barber as it went over his stick, but placed perfectly off the boards, and he'll clear it in. 45 seconds into this one. Of course, no score. Back and forth dump-ins here. Sage Dugas has it now. Dugas across the line, taking his shot, and Anderson steering that one aside. Dugas losing his stick, trying to work with Eliash down low. Eliash to the front, almost had a chance there to take a shot on Anderson, but it's cleared away by Miles Miller. Miller across the Knights line, far side, taking a shot, goes off the side of the net, picked up by Michael Santiago. And cleared to the front, nobody there to bang it home, so back come the Atlanta Knights with Dumont along the near side. Over from Massa. Massa doesn't know where the puck is. It goes behind everybody. Stone didn't even know where it was, but Rubin will find it off in the near circle. Rubin opting to go to an open wing. Nobody there as Trichette will pick it up for the Knights. Coming back the other way now, dumping it in deep inside Patriots territory. Robert Stone back there to chase. And he gets checked by Fenton. And it'll be Se Kim putting it up to the blue line and cleared out as Benz could not keep it in. The Patriots touch the puck, and they'll call that offsides.
Huh. In their defensive zone.
In their defensive zone. That's
face off at center. Weird. Sounds good to me.
Face off just outside the Patriots zone along the near side boards here at the Prince William Ice Center in Woodbridge, Virginia. Thank you all for tuning in this morning. Hope you have a full pot of coffee because we have a full day of hockey. As the EJHL South team will daunt us with their presence and try to rebound from last night's last-minute loss. Well, Fenton with it off in the far corner, trying to squeeze it to the front. Lamar will find it. Lamar back in the lineup today. I believe he was one of our scratches last night.
One of many.
One of many, for sure.
Good to have another body out on the ice.
And Kyle Powers, of course, back in the lineup as well. And Egan, too, after his game disqualification was served last night. And this one's another offside on Atlanta. 17:45 left here in the first. Not much on that scoreboard except for one shot for the Atlanta Knights.
Something to keep in mind for this game. Patriots got to make sure that the front of their net is cleared at all times. They got burned last night only once, but there were a number of opportunities where a defender had left a man errantly open in front of the net. So an improving point for their defense to step up on this.
Squeeze around to the near side boards. Welsh trying to control it, but it's picked away by McDonald. McDonald last night, of course, had two goals and an assist. As he gets his pocket picked by Nick Gross. Gibson clearing it right back into the Patriots zone. They're going to get a few changes on their side. Pop back over to Joe Welsh. Welsh back over to Lamar. Bradley Lamar, and his pass not hard enough there. Stallard picks it off, moves it to the front, trying to hook up there with Montagne. Montagne trying to take his shot through, but Stallard's going to have to push it up to the front with a shot from Elliott that goes off the side of the net. Stallard picking it up again. Stallard on his backhand trying to sweep it over backdoor to Elliott, but Elliott couldn't wrangle that one down as it was midair. Chasing it down, Montagne going with it. Welsh, Welsh pop it back over to Lamar. Lamar trying to move it along for DeBow, but it's up at the point for Harley. Harley takes his shot, blocked, Another attempt here as he tries to move it along for Elliott. Down low. A chance now. Along the side of the net. Trying to move that one to the front was Montagne. And a long toss on and saved by Anderson. Pushes it behind the goal line. Montagne back with it again. Montagne squeezing it back for Lamar. And he almost turned it over to Lamar, I beg your pardon. And now moving it up top. Gibson takes a shot. Stick to side by Anderson. Patriots trapped inside their own zone as Dugas puts it behind the goal line. And Lamar will squeeze it over to Barber. Barber getting rubbed off the puck there as he's pushed into the boards. Penalty. And now we're going to have a call against the Knights. So the first Metro DC DJs power play.
Oof, that was
of the day on an interference.
They got trapped inside their own zone there for a good minute and a half, 2 minutes. And penalty got them out of the doghouse there a little bit. And hopefully that we can see a much improved effort on the man advantage. Too many odd man rushes going back the other way when the Patriots had the man advantage yesterday. So time to set something up inside the zone, get a couple quality shots on goal, generate a scoring chance here, Stearns.
For sure. Yesterday's power play goal was provided from Micah DeBow on a nice setup from Nick Gross up front.
That was a pretty
good goal. And Ruben set it up, keeping the puck in along that far side board. So let's hear the call.
Atlanta penalty to number 16, Sage Dugas. 2 minutes for interference. Time of the penalty, 4 minutes.
And it's kept up top of the blue line. Reynolds at the top of the umbrella. Opts to go down low for Powers, but it's out of his reach. And the Knights will clear it all the way around the boards and down the length of the ice. Anderson will come out to leave it there for Reynolds. Patriots Power Plays are sponsored by Metro DC DJs. Check them out at MetroDCDJs.com today. Along the near side boards, up top to Reynolds. Cross ice over to Powers. Powers along the half boards, far side getting it around Massa, finding Egan down low. Back over to Powers. Powers having a little trouble there as he was pressed up hard by a couple of Knights players, including Fiorello. Now one-on-one back. Shorthanded are the Atlanta Knights.
Good defense.
A nice check there by Egan, but Zachary Egan draws a penalty. Reynolds will go to the box for a head contact.
Yeah, I'll give him that. I thought they were getting him for interference.
Interference, he had the puck.
I was going to say. he's got a case, but no, you're right. Head contact is going to be the call. And great defensive play by Reynolds. Reynolds if I'm not mistaken, was the one who lowered the boom yesterday and probably the best hit of the season. And we did catch it on video, which is good. We'll have to
clip that one, yeah.
Tube chop that one and get it up on the interweb for you.
Oh, for sure.
Potomac penalty to number 77, Matt Reynolds. 2 minutes for indirect contact to the head, roughing. Time of the penalties, 4:52.
Indirect contact to the head, roughing? Oh, it looked pretty direct to me. And it's fed to the front, getting around Anderson. They score. Jack Trichette opening the scoring on a 4-on-4 with 14:51 left here in the first.
Anderson got down way too quick on that one. Trichette just froze him as he came across the street, across the crease. Pretty patient with his shot and just backhanded right by the goaltender Anderson. They make quick work of that power play. 1-0 Knights.
Well, 4-on-4 they score.
Nevermore.
Hopefully, they can rebound from this immediately.
Knights goal, scoring his 10th goal of the season, number 17, Jack Trichette. Assisted by number 14, Matt Benz, and by number 13, Sam Kim. Time of the goal, 5:09.
This one goes right in on Anderson, and he holds on. 14:33 left here in the first, 1-0 Knights. 33 seconds left on the penalty to Sage Dugas. And then an abbreviated power play will be set up for the Atlanta Knights as the Patriots will go on a short Reebok hockey penalty kill. Face off one back up top to the point to Massa. Massa looking for a lane. Takes a shot deflected wide off of Fenton. And back to chase is Ventura. Ventura gets taken down by Lamar. Lamar trying to tie him up into the boards. Trying to kill some time here, but you know, it'd be nice to get the puck out the other way as they're about to go shorthanded in a few seconds. 10 seconds until the Atlanta Knights go on a power play. Ventura on his backhand, blocked up front. Up to the point, over to the near side, Massa. Massa along the half boards, being shadowed by Michael Santiago. And Ventura gets outworked by Winnett, and it comes over to Michael Santiago as we are shorthanded for the next 45 seconds. Michael Santiago will dump it in, and we'll get a penalty kill unit out for the Patriots. Massa along the near side, over to Elliott. Elliott through center to McDonald. McDonald still with it, trying to work his way around. He'll curl back up top to the blue line, dropping it there for Massa. Over to the far side to Stellert. Over to McDonald with a shot. He scores!
Wow.
Glove side high. It's Patrick McDonald making it 2-0 on a power play goal with 13:34 left here in the first.
Absolutely brilliant passing in the offensive zone by the Atlanta Knights. And that was a saucer pass right across the ice to McDonald, and he just roofed it on Anderson. And just like that, 2-0. And
credit Stallard on that beautiful pass over to McDonald. McDonald with a snipe up top.
Yeah, they've been doing that all season. That's going to be Stallard's 46th point, and I believe McDonald's 42nd point.
Knights goal, scoring his 20th goal of the season, number 15, Patrick McDonald. Assisted by number 28, Cole Stallard. And by number 20, Kale Massa. Time of the goal, 6:26.
13:20 left here in the first, 2-0 Atlanta Knights. As they'll pop on their first shot. On to Sean Davis. Face-off won by the Patriots up top. Welsh trying to keep it in, but it's squeezed over to Montagne. Montagne coming back the other way with Elliott taking a shot. Anderson to save the rebound. Left Juicy up front. Still loose up front.
Penalty.
And we're going to have a delayed call, and I believe this one's going to go to the Patriots. Oh, no, maybe the Knights. The Knights are arguing
running
here.
Running into the goaltender, and Anderson's down,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he is down. Holland, of course, backing him up as Guzik is still out of the lineup. His expected return time is 2 weeks. Anderson trying to get up on his own power, and Egan is telling Doc to go back to the bench. He's okay. He's just getting his bearings back. And so a power play will ensue here, as I was kind of confused, but I guess it's because the Patriots touched the puck and Anderson was down and hurt that they made the stoppage. So it makes sense.
Yep.
So a Metro DC DJ's power play. They are 0-for-1 this morning. 13:08 left here in the first. They are down 2-0 to Atlanta. So a very timely power play, to say the least.
Yeah, this is going to be something that they're going to have to work on for sure, but the shots have got to come from the point. At least get somebody in front of the net, screen the goaltender.
Atlanta penalty to number 23, Nick Elliott. 2 minutes for goaltender interference. Time of the penalty, 6:52.
So sitting for two, Nick Elliott. On the goaltender interference, but it's Zachary Egan for the Knights keeping it inside the Patriots zone. And now it'll be Robert Stone moving it ahead. A crowded left side here as it's dumped into the near corner. Harley will swing it around the boards and clear it all the way out into the neutral zone. Noah Rubin will chase it down. Rubin on his backhand over to Gross. Nick Gross with a drop pass there, left for DeBow. Mike DeBow trying to gain the zone, dumped in near the half boards, and a clearing attempt by Atlanta is foiled as DeBow drops it up top to Stone. Stone getting around two Knights players, leaving there for Gross, who takes his shot and easily gloved down by Davis. I'd like to take this moment to thank you all for tuning in this morning. We know that you are out there across the globe. We've had listeners check in across the globe over the years from Australia, but we know that we do have a parent out in the United Arab Emirates. I'd like to say hello to Mr. Winnett, who is out there all the way in the Middle East.
What time is it there?
Oh,
my goodness.
Man. It's got to be the perfect time to watch hockey. This one moved to the front. Loose up front. Oh, and a chance there for Powers to bury it, but he couldn't find it in his wheelhouse. Reynolds clearing it across over to the halfboard's far side, but it's sent down the length of the ice by the Knights, and Anderson is out to play. Reynolds looking to set things up here as we have 40 seconds left on the Metro DC DJ's power play. Powers trying to dump it in deep, but getting in the way of that one was Trichet. Trichet, of course, having the first goal in this contest, followed by a McDonald goal on a power play for the Knights. As it's dumped in to the near corner, Cal Massa trying to clear it up. That's kept in by the Patriots with Egan. That is our Egan we're talking about here. Miller winds up, takes a shot, and another easy save. The rebound, they score! There's no H key! It's a power play goal with 11:23 left here in the first.
You know, it's a big added presence to this lineup. Egan was out yesterday serving that suspension for the fight in the previous game, coming back in a big way, and that's just what the doctor ordered for these Potomac Patriots. A 2-1 score with 11:23 left to go here in the first period. This is this is a step in the right direction for this team, and Egan is a big body and certainly a presence on the power play, and he's strutting his stuff a little bit right now.
Patriots Metro DC DJ's power play goal, his fifth goal of the season by number 76, Jeff Eakin. Assisted by number 11, Miles Miller. Time of the goal, 8:37. That's Potomac goal.
Face off won by the Patriots. They try to put one in on Davis. And they already put one in past him as a recent goal from Egan. The fans and the coaching staff are lobbying for a penalty as the bow got taken out hard.
They had an argument there.
They did. You call head contact down here, why not there? You know, because he came up pretty high. And sent over to the near side to Robert Stone. Jeffrey Egan getting the goose egg off the board on the Patriots side. They got a power play goal. Kyle Powers moving it back over to Welsh. Welsh looking cross ice, but they're making a change. Ooh. Here comes McDonald. McDonald, far circle. Getting pressured there by Miller. And now we're going to have a delayed call to the Patriots. And Ruben will touch the puck. And Fiorello takes him down into the boards. Maybe he'll draw him in for one there. Well, the slashing call going to go to Ruben. So nothing drawn there on Fiorello, even though he hit him after the fact that the delayed call was being made. Oh, no, they're going to put him in there. No, he's shaking his head. No, close that door. Everyone else had the same idea as we did.
They tried. A for effort on that one.
Reebok hockey penalty kill coming up here with 10:25 left here in the first. The Knights have a 2-1 lead.
Potomac penalty to number 14, Noah Rubin. 2 minutes for slashing. Time of the penalty, 9:35.
Oh, what a glove save there by Anderson. A hot shot coming from the point from Harley.
Oh, we saw that through the screen. I had no idea, but flashing the leather. Nice save by Anderson.
Montagne trying to step in, but he has his pocket picked by Jeffrey Egan, who puts it up to the blue line. Not out. Kept in there tight at the blue line by Harley. Harley looking for a lane, but he sends it over to Montagne, who has his pocket picked, but he's going to go back, try to retrieve it there. But no, it's swept away by Jeffrey Egan and sent down the length of the ice. Here comes Judd Parker. Judd Parker putting on some gas there, but he couldn't get there in time as Davis sent it around the boards over to Stallard. Stallard through center ice across the blue line and in. Still with it. Back in the near corner he goes, all the way around over to the far corner, sending it up top to the point. Elliott looking for a lane, takes a shot, and that rebound was swept away. Very timely there by Reynolds as it was, I believe it was McDonald that was looking to pop it home back door. Harley along the near side with it up at the blue line now. Looking for a deflection up front and redirected by McDonald, but it goes wide. And backhanded to the front. It's loose up front. McDonald almost had a chance there to jam it home, but it sends the puck up top to Harley. Harley back over to McDonald. McDonald down low. And a chance now for Montagne. It looked like it may have hit a pad and went wide. On the far side boards, the Knights controlling the play now with Elliott. Elliott chasing it off into that far corner as Reynolds takes him out into the boards, but Montagne will pick up the puck. Montagne trying to work his way to the front, sending it up top there for Stellar, whose shot gets deflected out of play, and we'll have a stoppage. 8:56 left here in the first, 31 seconds left on the Reebok hockey penalty kill. And a penalty to Noah Rubin.
Good kill so far. They're trying to, they need some bigger bodies on this team. I think that's where they lack a little bit of the equality in stature with this other team here, the Atlanta Knights. The size is just not there to clear those bodies out in front of the net. And it's
not like there's an age difference either. They're pretty well balanced as far as 93s through 96s.
It's just that size that's getting the better of them, especially in these power plays and penalty kills.
That's funny. I would expect some 97s on these two teams, but there is none. And we have two 97s on the EJHL South team. So, okay. And now it's the Knights breaking out of their own zone as they have 10 seconds left on the power play, but it's moved back into the Knights zone by Egan. Barber making a change here. Now we're back to five-a-side hockey. So they've killed, I believe that would be their third, but they allowed one on the power play for the Knights. Michael Santiago moving it up along the boards here. Jeffrey Egan trying to move it through center. He does so using the boards. He still has it. With a pass over to Miller, and it was behind his back. It'll be chased down by the Knights. Getting there is Ryan Dumond, sending it back over to Massa. Massa on the near side, deflected all the way out through center, down the length of the ice, but it's deflected off the power, so no icing. Sent over to the near side. I went out over to Stone. Stone looking cross ice, trying to get to Powers. Powers does chip it ahead.
He's got Miller Santiago
in a foot race there with Benz. But Benz clears it around the horn and all the way out up to the near side blue line where Ventura will tap it ahead for McDonald. But it's too far out of his reach as Reynolds puts it ahead there now for Santiago. Michael Santiago. He's the only Santiago in the lineup today. The Knights breaking it out of their own zone with 7:20 left here in the first. 2-1 Atlanta. Speaking of which, they are offsides. We'll have a face-off in the neutral zone. Patriots hockey sponsored by Gatorade, the official sports drink of the Potomac Patriots.
It's been a good period so far, action-wise. Good flow back and forth. A couple of quick goals there for the Knights kind of hurt the momentum, but they're clawing back. They got that goal and the power play from Egan, and a little bit at a time here.
Chiseling it away.
Yep.
You know, they need to play 60 minutes of hockey. Last night we saw them kind of collapse halfway through that second period, and hopefully they can, you know, keep the momentum throughout here. As this one goes right in on Anderson, and he holds on for the faceoff. Just a reminder, after this game we have Eastern Junior Hockey League South action as the Atlanta Knights and the Potomac Patriots do battle here at the Prince William Ice Center. Stay tuned to crossicefeed.com for that live broadcast immediately after this one. Also, don't forget to check out crossicefeed.com. And if you want to contact us with feedback or interest in our services, check out the contact tab and submit your feedback or request. And here comes a chance now. Stellar coming in on goal, taking a shot, and Anderson squared up nicely with that one and makes the save. No rebound coming, and a faceoff, Will, as it'll be off to his left.
Save by Anderson. Squared off with the shooter on that one. Gave him absolutely nothing to look for in terms of the lower half or even the upper half at the top of the net there. And playing pretty solid. Faced 12 shots so far in this period.
And the Knights putting it up top to Gibson. Gibson over to Elliott. Elliott looking for a lane, deflected on. And Anderson will hold on as Stallard gets pushed and shoved for being in that blue paint. You know, you make fun of me for having an iPad, and yet you give me sparkling ice water.
Yeah, it's water. Does it have flavor?
It does.
A lot more exciting than what you're drinking.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Oh,
Frankel taking out a body at neutral with Harley, but Stallard's going to find the loose change. He'll carry it off over into the far corner with a pass up front. Nobody there except for a few Patriots players, including Jeffrey Egan, who puts it directly on to Davis. Davis is going to hold on as Frankel and Harley get tied up, and now there goes Harley's stick.
Harley dropped his stick with the help of Frankel.
Is that how we're going to phrase it?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, Frankel's a big guy. We'll give him that. I would love to see him, maybe with the man advantage, just parked in front of the net.
Oh, yeah.
Deflecting shots, taking like the Eric Lindros approach of things. I mean, big guy in front, just trying to get something going in front of the goaltender.
Yeah. And, you know, those goals don't sound pretty, but, you know, a goal is a goal. Garbage goal, it's a goal. Here come the Knights, though, the other way. He's going to get up top to the point. On the near side for Massa. Massa moving it down low for Fenton. Trichette calling for it as he has Kim behind the net trying to work for it. Kim will find it as Welsh couldn't. And it's moved along over to the near corner where Powers will set it up for Santiago. Michael Santiago with it now through center. Trying to hook up with the pass through traffic for Miller. Deflected on, no icing. Miller trying to work for it along the far boards. He gets tied up by Dumond. Trying to scrum for it is Fenton. Keenan Fenton trying to move it along, but Dumond hooks down Miller. No call. Comes over to Santiago, but Massa got in the way of that one as it's cleared up over to the half boards for Fenton. Fenton moving it along there for Kim. Kim in a race up for Powers, and yes, the Knights will get called for an offsides as Trichette was trapped inside the Patriots zone. 5:07 left here in the first. 2-1 score. Atlanta Knights in the lead. You know, they were kind of, for the most part, in the driver's seat in this first period, but ever since Jeffrey Egan's goal, the tides have seemed to have turned a little bit.
A little bit, yeah.
This one's deflected up in the neutral zone, taken the other way by McInnes, who takes his shot, Looks like this is his first shift out there for the Knights.
Good name.
Benz chasing it. Back in front of his net. Gets the pass over the stick of Parker. McDonald moving it along for Ventura. And they're going to go offside yet again. Have you been keeping track?
The offsides? We're almost in double digits.
Oh.
And I figure there was a good flow to last night's game. This one's a little bit choppy because of all these offsides. Certainly plays in the favor of the team that's missing four or five key players.
And we certainly got a late start, too, so this might carry
when
on.
When don't we
next
get a
game.
Late start?
Well, yesterday we got an early start all
no,
around.
No, no. You know what? I rescind my comment.
There you go. And it looked like Ventura was offside, believe it or not. But
I know, I believe it. I'm going to believe that one.
Speaking of Ventura, he puts it up top for Harley. Harley winds up, takes a shot, glove down by Anderson. Robert Stone with the hardest stone there as he won't take any from the Knights who are parked up front. That was Rick Fiorello trying to be the agitator in front of Anderson.
Maybe had himself a goal yesterday. Down to our left-hand side.
Patrick Anderson didn't see that one come through, but it went wide. Goes over to the near corner to Reynolds. Reynolds trying to move it up along the boards. And it is found by Jeffrey Egan, who sends this one past everybody, and this one will come back in icing. Stop and start, stop and start, stop and start. Ice, ice baby it is. 15-6 shots in favor of Atlanta. They're finding every outlet to throw the puck on to Anderson. Face off to his left. Won by the Patriots. Over to the near side boards for Nick Gross. Gross putting it high into the air, trying to find Frankel through center. Frankel moving it ahead of Harley, and he does clear it into the Knights zone. Harley taking him out on a check. John Gibson with it for Atlanta. And trying to cut off that pass was Jeffrey Egan, but he'll find it out in the neutral zone, trying to move it over to Nick Gross. Nick Gross tagging up on a delayed offside. Reynolds will find it back towards his blue line. So he's getting roughed up there by Zachary Egan for the Knights. Over to the near side, Riley Winnett chasing it down. Winnett putting it on his backhand over to Reynolds along the half boards. Reynolds is gonna duck back towards the goal line, putting it high into the air. And Zachary Egan is going off on a change, so he didn't see it coming his way, but Harley will step up into the play. Harley taking out Jeffrey Egan in the process, but no call there as Egan was kinda waving at the referee when that took place. Comes over to the near side. Egan putting on his backhand up to the blue line. Not out. Kept in by John Gibson. Elliott winds up. Takes a shot. Stick to side by Anderson. Over to the far side. Montagne with it now. Montagne had it picked away from him, but Frankel will shoot it right into his bench. Yet another stoppage with 3:04 left here in the first. 2-1 Atlanta. Face off to the right of Anderson. Reminder, this is the Cross Ice Feed with David Stearns, Brian Schrems, and Jason Wakely. Check us out at crossicefeed.com and like us on Facebook or follow us on Twitter at Cross Ice Feed. Kyle Powers trying to hunt that one down, but it's ever so elusive and picked up by the Knights, but then it's turned over to Ruben. Ruben on his backhand to Miller. And it's deflected through by Massa, and Miller will pick it up. Miller with a side angle shot that just goes wide. Santiago trying to keep it in, but it goes out of his reach, and it'll be picked up by Stone at the red line. Ruben off the far boards, trying to hook up with Powers, comes back over to Ruben, over to the near side now for Santiago. Santiago looking to get the equalizer here, going into the first intermission. Santiago taking out his man. Takes out Dumont. Dumont's going to squirt that puck over to the far side. And squeezed up along the far boards and out for Trichet. Trichet going one-on-one with Stone. Trichet trying to work around Stone. Anderson's going to reach out and glove this one down as it floats towards the net. And everybody else goes into the net. In the process, Stone and Trichet collide, and Stone appears injured.
Penalties?
Not exactly sure if that is the case. Yeah, it looks like we are going to get a roughing call.
And Stone is hurt.
Stone is rolling around, and we will see what results of this. That was a hard collision in. So Dr. Felix Yeskin will check him out to ensure that he is okay.
Hopefully he just got the wind knocked out of him.
No, it looks like it might be more than that. He's trying to straighten him out here, and it is a knee. boy. Stone is not one that you want out of your lineup. Fourth leading scorer on this team. He's more of a playmaker at that. 15 assists on the season.
Big smart defender, too. He's definitely bringing size into this whole thing. And are they?
Mm-hmm. He's definitely instrumental on that power play as well.
Yeah, he's going to need some help getting up. Yep, this is going to be a big loss for the Potomac Patriots.
Well, that knee is going to take him out, so. They're going to help him off the ice, so. 2:07 remains here in the first, and yes, there is a power play resultant of that action.
Insult to injury, it's against the Patriots, so.
Yeah. They're going to call Noah Rubin.
Oh, he is in a world of hurt.
Mm. Yeah. So the bench a little bit thinner.
To number 14, Noah Rubin. 2 minutes for roughing. Time of the penalty, 17:57.
Rubin will sit for two. And a Reebok hockey penalty kill. And he'll sit for two or less as we have 2 minutes left here in the first. Atlanta looking to widen the lead, but this one saucered all the way down to Davis. Davis dropping it off behind his net for Harley. A pass over to Stallard over to the near side to Fenton. Getting it around Reynolds, but Reynolds will move that puck back along the half boards. Picked up by Harley. Harley up top, the top of the umbrella, looking over to the near side to Fenton. Fenton pushing it through to the front, but Kim couldn't get a deflection in the right direction as it goes off over to the near side and cleared down the length of the ice by Shane Barber. 1:10 to kill, 1:20 to play here in the first period. Harley leading the rush through center now over to Kim. Kim having trouble with it. Reynolds kicking it around. He's got it between his feet. And he has it picked away by Trichet. Trichet over to Stallard. Stallard on top of the far circle over to the near circle to Harley. Harley moving his way back to the point. Taking a shot, Anderson the save, and it goes out of play. And we'll have 56.6 remaining here in the first with 49 seconds left on Rubin's penalty.
Puck changed directions on Anderson. Got his pad down to make the save. Nice save by Anderson. He's going to see potentially 20 shots in this period. That puts him on pace for 60.
And Montagne trying to find it through the feet of Lamar. Lamar moving it back up top. Not out, kept in by Stallard. Over to Elliott, down low, back to the front. No, and a backdoor try for Harley that went in on goal, but Patriots will try to find it here. Judd Parker working hard for it, but Harley still with it. Harley dropping the pass up top to Elliott. Over to the near side to Stallard. Stallard walking in on goal. What a great blocker saved by Anderson. 30 seconds to play here in the first, 21 seconds left on the kill. And Jeffrey Egan will find it and ice it down to Davis. 20 seconds left in the first. 10 seconds left on the penalty. One last rush for the Knights. Elliott along the near side. Stopping, turning, getting checked by Barber, but the puck still controlled by the Knights. McDonald looking to the front. Here comes a backhand shot. Oh, and a great pad save by Anderson. Last second here, and we're back to five on five, but that'll do it. Period will expire. The Knights are up 2-1. So similar position to last night where they were down 1-0. Instead, this time around, they're down 2-1. The difference maker, of course, being the power play goal. McDonald popped in. And that's where we stand right now.
Not a bad effort, though. I mean, you got to get some more shots on goal, but
you think? 37-16 were the shots of last night.
Yeah, and they're on pace for that again today.
20-6 is what you see up there on the scoreboard.
But
stay
they converted
tuned.
One.
Oh, well, they converted one on six, so that's those numbers look good. And that mantra, shoot the puck, shoot the puck.
Yes, sir.
Has to be carried on in that locker room. So 40 minutes to go. Stay tuned. It's David Stearns, Brian Schrems, Jason Wakely here on the Cross Ice Feed as Atlanta leads the Potomac Patriots with a score of 2-1. Stay tuned. Welcome back, everybody, to the Prince William Ice Center in Woodbridge, Virginia. David Stearns with Brian Schrems. After 20 minutes of play, Atlanta leading the Potomac Patriots 2-1. As we talk about the scoring in that period, we saw goals from Trichet and McDonald. And then course, Jeffrey Egan.
Little PP action.
Miller. Yeah, little power play goal. Drawing them within one. So here we go, second period underway. One back over to Gibson. Gibson dropping it off there for Harley. Sent ahead for Stallard, out of his reach. Reynolds will get there. No, this one's going to miss everybody there. And they moved by Ventura to the front. Trying to get a hold of it there was Montagne. But now it's going to be Reynolds back behind his keeper. Turned over, but it's popped back behind the goal line. back, gone. That's my Chris Berman, and that'll
little
be the last
Berman
time
action,
I do that.
Huh? Don't do that again.
Miller trying to work his way around Harley, and hey, he gets hauled down, and that'll draw a penalty against the Atlanta Knights. So a Metro DC DJ's power play, that'll be their, what, fifth try at it? But they've
we've had abbreviated power plays. We've had
So far they are 1-for-4, and they're looking to go 2-for-5.
Just a reminder, they are without Stone right now, as he took a
nasty hit.
It looks like he's got some knee issues, and I doubt we'll see him back. So big presence lost in the back end. However, gonna throw Egan back there, and
Atlanta penalty to number 4, Brad Harley. 2 minutes for hooking. Time of the penalty, 36 seconds.
Sent off into the near corner for Barber. Barber back behind the net, but it's cut off and sent down the length of the ice by Ryan Dumont. So it's a Metro DC DJs power play. Visit them at metrodcdjs.com to book them for your event today. And if you like that voice on the public address, then you should definitely go to metrodcdjs.com and book them.
Imagine them at your wedding.
Oh, yeah. And Dubon's trying to free it there. I heard that. Now the Patriots battling for it off in the far corner. Massa trying to kick it free there, but Egan trying to bury it through to the front. He had two Patriots waiting, but instead it'll be sent out the other way. That's a delayed offside there, and he was ready to lift his arm, but he will not go for the delayed call. 1 minute left on the Metro DC DJ's power play. Just a couple of shots, but nothing really challenging for Davis. Chased down now by Miller and Massa. Miller losing his stick in the process. And that puck is underneath him somewhere. And it squirts free and is sent down the length of the ice by Dumont. Anderson setting it up there for Reynolds. Reynolds looking. He finds Parker. Judd Parker coming across the line. Parker still with it, trying to get around Trichet. Trichet poked it free there for a second. It'll be picked up. Sent over to the near side. Reynolds winds up, takes a shot, and it goes wide. Nice setup there by Nick Gross. Gross within the far corner. And a drop pass there for Parker. Parker looking to the front of the net. He's got Mike in the balance. Loose up front. It's swept away by the Knights. Not out. Well, McInnes tried to clear it out. A second try here by Trichet. We'll send it all the way down to Anderson. 5 seconds left as they will go 1-for-5 on the man advantage this morning. 17:25 left here in the second. 2-1 Knights. David Stearns with Brian Schrems and Jason Wakely with Cross Ice Feed Crew. Here comes a chance up front. Oh, man, oh, man. Trying to bury that one home was Ventura, who went toe-to-toe with Anderson. Sloppy control of the puck and deflected
on. Nice
great save by Anderson as the redirect from Ventura went straight on. Up top at the point, kept in by the Knights. The Knights controlling the play now. Ventura along the side of the net, but Anderson will reach out and hold on with 16:57 left here in a second.
Two big saves there by Anderson.
Huge saves.
Paycheck this morning so far.
Oh, certainly.
And a couple of mistakes down in their own zone there. The Patriots have got to clean that up just a little bit.
Need to clean up those turnovers a little bit better. And it's maintenance inside their own zone is crucial. Because Atlanta will take advantage of it, that's for sure. Fiorello dumping it back behind the goal line, but it'll be greeted there by Rubin. Rubin sending it around the horn, but Santiago can't clear it out. Up through to the slot. Now Santiago will find it. Santiago looking across the blue line, along the near sideboards. Into the corner it goes. Being tracked down now by the Knights, and it'll be Sage Dugas sending it through center. Up ahead now for Elliott. Elliott looking. Gives it over to Fiorello with a shot that goes wide. The rebound goes off the side of the net. Wow. Coming in there hot was Fiorello, and none of the Patriots players like that. He took a real stab at Anderson.
Yeah, did. Anderson clearly had that puck. He went in there stick first, and Anderson's already been down once this game. The last thing his teammates need to see out of him is an injury, especially with how plagued this team is with injuries right now. And they're just They're doing what they're taught, protect your goaltender.
Can't fault them for that.
And Powers is going to sit for two. And Dugas is going to sit for two.
It's surprising. I thought it was actually Fiorello that went hot in there.
I just put somebody in the box.
Had expectations, I guess. Well, the faceoff will be to the left of Anderson. Nothing up on the board, so we'll get the call on those penalties.
Here are the penalties. To Atlanta's number 16, Sage Dugas, 2 minutes for cross-checking. Potomac's number 24, Kyle Powers, 2 minutes for roughing. Time of the penalties, 3:35.
Stallard with the puck, winding up, taking a shot. Guns off the backboards and along the near side it goes. Harley keeping it active there as he gets around Frankel. Frankel takes out his man. There's the body. Man, Frankel's got size, and man, does he use it when he does. And Nick Gross trying to track the puck down. Harley sending it around the horn over to the near side. Montagne with it now. Montagne leading the rush with a pass over to Stallard. Nice reception of that pass. Stallard sets it up front over to Harley, but Harley couldn't get the deflection through. Gibson chase it down in his own zone, sending it around the horn over to Stallard. Stallard will ease it through center. Over to Kim. Montagne kicking it back to Stallard, literally. But Jeffrey Egan will find it. He can't get a solid rep on his pass, and he has his stick chopped by Elliott, and Elliott goes down and takes a tumble. Egan coming across the line onside, sending it around back behind the net. Massa going to try to get there first. He does so, beating out DeBow to the puck, and now he sends it over to the near side to Dumont. Dumont with a pass through center to Trichet out of his reach, and Reynolds will send it back to the red line. Stopped up by Elliott, and it hits a body going on to the bench. They're going to call that one offsides.
Oh, are you sure?
Yeah, that's offsides. It's a shame, because it did hit that extra body going off the ice, but his foot was not on the ice.
Got close.
Yeah. Barber winning the faceoff over to DeBow. Chopped back through center, but Massa will pick it up at his blue line, turning it over there as Barber chips it in. Barber chasing it down, going toe-to-toe with Dumond. Opts to go for the body. He'll find the puck and chip it back over to DeBow. DeBow moving it up to the front, but it does not make its way through traffic, and Fenton will guide it ahead now for Trichet. Trichet on a return pass from Kim, coming in 2-on-1. Down to Kim, and oh boy, he missed that one. That one is looking dangerous. Anderson was teeing up with the man with the puck. As you should, the defender takes the man without the puck. Now Dumont back into his own zone, going D-to-D now with Massa. Massa over to the near side, turned over. DeBow cut off that pass, and he backhands it to Massa. Up along the boards and kept in by Rubin. Parker, the turnaround shot, easy save there for Davis. Dumont trying to peel away from Miller, turns the puck over to Parker. Parker, turnaround shot, goes right in on Davis and some trouble controlling that puck.
I think Davis wanted to play it, and his defender didn't want him to play it. And
make a decision.
Regardless, we'll get a stoppage. 13:58. Left to go here in the second period. Still, those shots seem to be eluding the Potomac Patriots. They got 8 on the board for the game here, and it's going to take a lot more than that to beat a goaltender who's got a 2-1-2 goals against average, I'll tell you that much.
One up top, Lamar teeing it up, and it gets deflected behind the cage. And assistant coach there, or associate coach, Steve Sherman, is looking for something. And McDonald taking out his man, and the Knights will pop it in. Ventura. It's settled down there by Santiago. Santiago trying to send it around the horn over to Welsh, but the puck had a funny bounce. Ventura sweeping it behind the net to McDonald. McDonald setting up Ventura up front, but he gets taken out by Lamar. Up to the point, not out, kept in by McInnes. Now it's McInnes taking his shot, steered aside by Anderson. McDonald putting it up top to the blue line. The shot coming through, deflected on, but a blocker save by Anderson. Fiorello dropping it there for Ventura. Ventura kind of moving along there, but it'll be picked up by Welsh in the far corner. And we're going to have a whistle here. Not sure what we're calling. Looks like the faceoff will come outside, as I believe they're ruling it on a glove pass. Yeah. That seems to be the case.
And Anderson's having himself a good game today. You know, his defense has been there for him, too, in times where he wasn't able to snatch up that rebound. But you know, a good overall showing for Anderson. He is on his way to seeing 50-plus shots today, that's for sure.
25-9 in shots right now with 12:49 left here in the second. Atlanta still holding on to a 2-1 lead. Comes over to the near side to Stallard. Stallard coming up along the boards and around the horn over to Anderson. Anderson coming out to play. Sets it up along the far side. Montano is going to pick it up, trying to shovel it to the front. Stallard was waiting there, clapping along. Nick Gross through center, trying to find Frankel. Frankel deflecting it down, no icing. It does not make its way far enough as Harley will pick it up along the half boards and sends it over to the opposite side. Montagne backhanding it in, down the length of the ice. No icing there as Winnett's going to get there first. And he gets checked off the puck as he tried to clear it around. They'll get it back along his side and trying to make an effort there as Elliott. But it's cleared all the way out in the neutral zone where Harley will pick it up. A lot of back and forth, but not much of a solid setup going on here for either team. So this one's no icing as it's deflected onto Anderson.
Better flow to this period at least.
It is
stop and go.
It is good back and forth, but yeah, the stop and go in that first period almost killed me. Oh, Nicky Grosch tossing one on, and Davis easily reaches out with the glove and holds on. Just a reminder, Eastern Junior Hockey League South action will follow this game immediately as the Atlanta Knights will take on the Potomac Patriots here at the Prince William Ice Center. So stay tuned for a full day of hockey. Get that coffee pot ready, huh? Goes over to the far side, Dumont trying to move it out, but it's kept in by the Patriots, Parker. Parker didn't have anybody waiting down below the goal line. So Dumont's going to play it off of a partition, not off the referee's helmet. It looked like it almost bopped him in the head, but the Patriots trying to maintain some activity here in the night zone. Instead, it's cleared out and deflected through to the neutral zone by Zachary Egan and all the way back into the Patriots zone. Being chased down by Lamar. Lamar trying to move it up. Barber trying to fight off a check there to keep the puck shoveling along there. It's kept in at the blue line nicely there by Elias. Elias looking to make a change. Massa's going to take his place, but the puck does go across the blue line. It wasn't across the blue line completely, Massa. You actually had it onside. But he opts to go back the other way to regroup in the neutral zone. Some last second change is made by the Knights. Some rough stuff behind the play.
Oh, there's an elbow.
An elbow not being called there, as Ooh. Mr. Schrems had pointed out. Parker trying to beat out the race to the puck, but it'll be picked up and sent out through neutral by Massa. Massa still staying with it. Pinching up high into the play. Massa trying to work his way in goal, but Rubin stick that one aside off into the corner. Turned over to Miller. Miller coming along the right wing with 10:20 left here in a second. Knights up 2-1. Miller still trucking for it down here in the near corner, getting around McInnes. Powers is going to try to get his stick in there. As it's deflected over to the near side where Fenton will play it up along the boards. Not out, kept in by Welsh. Welsh putting it behind the goal line. McInnes will find it. And up through the middle over to Kim. Kim coming back 3-on-2. Gets a pass over to Fenton. Fenton having trouble handling it. And Fenton will lose his stick in the process. Welsh trying to put it up along the boards and out. Up for Santiago, but a nice poke there by McInnes to keep it in for the moment. But Miller will come back for it. Sitting up at the blue line, 3-on-3, 4-on-3. Now here comes a shot. Nobody there up front to deflect it through, but it comes up to the near blue line, kept in by Welsh. Welsh putting it down low. Benz will find it back behind his keeper. And the back pass behind the net. Powers is back there to try to give McInnes a bit of a time, but McInnes is going to peel away with it now along the far side. Oh, he gets back checked nicely there by Powers, but he wrangles him down. That was a missed call there, I'd hate to say it, but here comes a deflection shot on. Davis making the save off the pad, and rebound, he swallows it up. Frankel getting into a shoving match behind the net with Fenton. I think Powers got away with a hook there.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, very fortunate that the referees did not call that.
Good action in the offensive zone for the Patriots. Haven't seen this in a while. Broke double digits in shots. Faceoff coming to the right here of Davis. Good scoring opportunities here and there. And
yep.
You know, they're keeping him at bay at the other end. Anderson's having himself a good game.
Frankel still in a shoving match, but with another partner this time. Now here come the Knights. McDonald's trying to wind up, take his shot. Gross trying to set up Frankel. Oh, and the pass. Couldn't handle it through, but it got deflected down, so no icing. Gibson going into the boards with Frankel. Nicky Gross back there to trail. Nobody there to support. They're kind of going on a 2-3 system here. A 2-1-2 system coming into the zone.
Amir, has this line been out there for about 2 minutes now?
Well, they have a depleted bench, so anything's possible.
That's true.
They may have already had a change, and you just didn't even notice. And they're already back out there. 8:40 remains here in the second, and Atlanta comes in on the offsides. Atlanta up 2-1, of course, in this game. Patriots hockey is sponsored by Metro DC DJs. Check them out at metrodcdjs.com. Also, they are sponsored by the Spine and Joint Institute. Visit them at sjinstitute.com, located in Fairfax on Old Lee Highway. Visit them for your chiropractic and joint needs, and book your appointment with Dr. Felix Yeskin and Dr. Maria Schaefer today. I've been seeing them and feeling a little bit better.
It's good.
The knees are coming back.
Oh, boy.
It only took three doctors. I think I found the right one. And he is the team doctor for the Patriots, no less. We got some details on a special guest coming here to the Prince William Ice Center, so stay tuned for those details. And now it's Parker leading it up to the front. Nobody there. But now Parker will get it. Nice work there by Micah DeBow. Parker coming along with a shot to the front. Oh, and he had Barber looking there to deflect it through, but Davis made the save. And the Knights will clear it out, coming back 2-on-1. Barber trying to get back into the play. Here come the Knights with a shot and a save by Anderson. Opting to take that shot was Elliott. Elliott feeding it to the front, trying to find Montagne, but it'll be picked up by Welsh for the Patriots. Along the near side for Micah DeBow with a pass through center for Judd Parker. Parker winds up, takes a shot right in into the glove of Davis, who will play it out along the near side boards. Stallard, the captain for the Knights, with a pass along the far side blue line. And I believe that was Zachary Egan coming off the bench. And here comes a long distance shot from Sage Dugas right into the glove of Anderson. February 28th, be here at the Prince William Ice Center as Bill Clement will make an appearance. He will have a motivational speech for all those in attendance, permitting that there is room. And also, we're going to try to get him up here on the broadcast.
That'd be awesome.
We do have the head coach and general manager of the EJHL South team, RJ Ziegler, working hard to make that possible. How cool would it be
to have
an intermission report with Bill Clement? Oh, been following him for many years. Now he's working for the Flyers on the intermission reports.
That's unfortunate for him.
Of watching him on ESPN with Gary Thorne. Oh,
I like
that
those
was
two.
A duo. Oh, yeah. How many video games with those two, huh? Yeah, the Patriots dumping it into the Knights zone as Benz is back there to get it, and we're going to have a delayed call for boarding against the Knights, and Zachary Egan looks to be the guilty party. So we're going to go for a sixth try on the Metro DC DJs power play. They are 1-for-5 this morning. 6:48 remains here.
2-for-6 sounds pretty good at this point.
It does.
You know, despite being outshot, I wouldn't necessarily say this team's been outplayed. It's been kind of a weird game in that sense for Potomac. They're not shooting the puck as much as they should be, but they're maintaining in this game.
Atlanta penalty to number 19, Zach Egan. 2 minutes for boarding. Time of the penalty, 13:12.
And this one's cleared down immediately, so 1:45 left on the Metro DC DJs power play. Once again, visit them at metrodcdjs.com to book them for your celebration. Reynolds loving that one down, playing it into the zone. Patriots got a tag up here as Harley's back there to chase for the Knights. Harley finding an opening up through center. Say Kim with it now. Kim putting that one on to Anderson, who steers that one easily aside. Harley down low working on the forecheck on this penalty kill for the Knights. Trichette as well trying to work it out from the pile. We have three Patriots in there and two Knights. And Powers is looking for it. It's under a pile of bodies. They're killing off a lot of time on this penalty. 1 minute to go on the Metro DC DJs power play. 5:50 left in the second. 2-1 Knights. And Kyle Powers is getting tied up by Jack Trichette, and he could not free himself. He's going to call them both. I find that hard to believe. Powers was just trying to get his arm out of.
Well, Powers ain't going.
Trichette, no, he pointed. He went both. Both doors are open. I'm not sure what Powers is getting called for.
Thinking Powers is a little surprised that he's getting that call.
Okay, this is going to be interesting. If he called what I think he did on those two players. It makes absolutely no sense.
I think he was just tired of it.
No, get ready for it. Get ready for it. Here it comes.
Here are the penalties to Atlanta's number 17, Jack Trichet. 2 minutes for slashing. Potomac's number 24, Kyle Powers. 2 minutes for roughing. Time for the penalties, 14-17.
Where was a slash in the rough? I saw a hold. Makes no sense.
Slash is his go-to. Here we go.
Riley Winnett up at the top of the slot, and a shot goes wide. Nick Gross picking up the rebound off in the far corner. They are on a 25-second power play. 5-on-4. Those penalties are not up on the board. They're going to serve their two and wait for a whistle. And Parker, along the side angle shot, goes right into the glove of Davis. Winnett was not happy with that as he slapped his stick on the ice.
Yeah, a good opportunity from the top of the slot there. Wasn't able to hit the net, but you know, the power play is improving. They're cycling the puck more and more. This is what they should be doing, and hopefully get a few more quality shots on goal here.
And that's going to have to put on the wheels here because Stallard is coming back hot. Stallard outplaying him. Yeah, he had a lot of speed on that one as this one's jumbled up front and held on to by Anderson. 3 seconds left on the penalty. Two. Number 19, Zachary Egan. He'll rejoin his team here. So we have 4:51 remaining in the second. A great back and forth period. 2-1 score. No scoring in this period so far. Patriots Hockey is sponsored by YBY Fitness. Visit them at YBY360.com. There's a shot deflected through and hits the protective netting and goes out of play.
It was a sad day when we lost ESPN hockey feeds. And you know, you'd think with the popularity, well, not after the lockout, but with the popularity that it gained in the years after that 2004 lockout, you'd see a little bit of a resurgence, maybe a game of the week or something, but not to be.
Yep. They've totally disregarded hockey except for having maybe Matt Barnaby. Oh, wait, never mind. Barry Melrose show up once in a while on the broadcast.
Oh, what a
to give their 30 seconds. But I apologize to our sponsor, YBY Fitness. Their website is, in fact, ybynow.com. McKinnis taking his shot, and it's deflected high and back into the far corner with 4:08 left here in a second. We are at 5-a-side hockey. Being chased down now, Lamar and Barber trying to work for it, but it's swept free by the Knights, picked up by Santiago. Santiago having trouble handling it, but he does turn it around and send it up top to the blue line, not out. Kept in by Benz. Benz looking up with McDonald along the far circle. McDonald turns, shoots, saves.
Boy, they're just getting.
They're getting the runaround.
Yeah, I mean, what is it going to take to call a penalty for digging in on Anderson like that?
I know. It's just the stick stabs, you know.
It only
takes one injury,
I guess. The only fight I've ever been in was a hockey fight, and I had my stick slashed or my wrist slashed too many times playing when I was younger, and I went after the guy. So I'm whoa!
Frankel taking care of business. Kim went in hot for the check, and, he did not get the result he wanted.
You got to think Anderson's getting a little fed up with the chips after the play here.
So. Frankel having trouble with these bouncing passes, you know. That's like the third one I've counted in this period that has not worked out in his favor. Yeah, back the other way. Frankel looking to hook up through
good
center.
Look.
Does get it for Gross, but Gross being tied up there by Gibson. Gibson staying on him, but the puck moves up top for Frankel there along the side of the net. He takes out his check again.
I don't think he means to do it.
No, they just run into him.
Kepkin, keep.
Nice kick there by Reynolds. Reynolds looking for Egan. Frankel is parked up front, but they just can't get the puck to him. It's along the side of the net now. No, nobody there to bury it home. And the Knights are going to come back the other way with Fenton. Fenton trying to get around Reynolds.
Good
Reynolds
play by
takes
Reynolds.
Him out nicely. Great work ethic by Reynolds on Fenton there. Say Kim with it now along the near side, digging it down low. Rubin. Swinging it around over to the far boards. Micah DeBow kicking that one along. Comes up over to the far side. Blue line kept in by Harley. Harley lofting that one into the air. And Elliott on his backhand trying to move it to the front. Beg your pardon, that's Eliash. That's a good hockey name right there, folks.
Eliash and McKinnis on the same team. I'd take that any
other
week.
How about that, huh? good names. Kind of like Turgeon for the EJHL South team. Yeah, no elbow being called there. Yeah, they're going to call it. Good catch, Mr. Shrimps.
Or rough.
Charging.
Wow. Charging.
There was a cornucopia of calls you could have chosen from. Just kind of take your pick.
Well.
Yeah, boarding, charging, elbowing. Oh, boy.
We have five boarding calls in yesterday's game.
Yeah.
Five, six boarding calls.
Sage Dugas is going to sit for his second penalty of this game. I believe we do have
you
the Dugas
say?
Tuning in. Hi, down there in Atlanta.
seventh times a charm is what I usually
seventh
say.
Seventh times a charm.
That's what I usually say. That's my creed. That's my motto.
A penalty to number 16, Sage Dugas. 2 minutes for charging. Time of the penalty, 17:54.
Saying shout out to the Dugas family that I know watch the games here on Cross Ice Feed. And thank you all who are scattered about in the south and elsewhere watching us today. This one's cleared all the way down the length of the ice. It's a Metro DC DJs power play once again. Check them out, metrodcdjs.com. Plenty of advertising for Jared Ronski and his business. They do a fine job. The public address and the music, and all sorts of things. He's an all-around great entertainer. Now this one's trapped up in the far corner, is trying to shovel it free as Kyle Powers. Jeffrey Egan sending it up for Miller with a side angle shot, but holding his post there was Sean Davis. Sent on along the half boards and all the way up top. Miller with a behind-the-back pass over to Reynolds. Reynolds dropping it in the slot, and it comes up to Miller. Deflected through. It's loose up front, and Davis gloves that one down. It was left juicy up in front. 1:02 left here in the second. 56 seconds left on the Metro DC DJs power play.
What happens when you shoot the puck? Rebounds in front of the net. Just toss it on. See what happens. You got a big guy like Egan up front. Yeah. Might as well. He's already got one today.
I mean, look at the scoreboard. It speaks volumes. It's 2-1 Atlanta. Atlanta has 30 shots, and Patriots have 15.
It's the first time I've understood math in that regard.
High stick down by Noah Rubin, and he plays it, resulting in a faceoff that'll come all the way back into the Patriots zone. 55.5 seconds left in the second period. And I was talking with Coach Little and Coach Sherman before the game, and you know, last night was a bit of a rough game for them. And, you know, they seemed a little upbeat this morning. They really did.
And they should be heading into the second intermission here. The team's played well.
They have. And hopefully they can keep it at a one-goal game here. But they're on the power play now, and they're trapped inside their own zone. And it's turned over to Rubin now, who's being pressured hard by McDonald. And Rubin taking care of business, taking McDonald out. Lead pass ahead for Parker. Parker trying to get ahead of Harley, who taps the puck back, and it's cleared down by Gibson. 25 to play here in the second, 19 on the power play. Along the near side for Micah DeBow. DeBow deflecting a pass. Gibson, no. Gibson actually stopped it up and kept it out of his zone. Parker's pass over to Nick Gross can't be handled there as Harley will find it along the far side of the neutral zone. In on goal with a shot right into Anderson, who holds on. 8.6 seconds left in the second period and 2 seconds left on Dugas' penalty.
Now the Patriots have come further than they did yesterday in terms of a complete game. They have put in 40 full minutes here. And this game is still close. It's going to come down to a solid third period. They have to capitalize with those man advantages, though. They are working on a seventh one going to. And now a seventh one going to waste here. Not
Whoa, and a great save there. Trying to push it up front out of the Knights with a flurry of activity.
Oof.
Round out that period. But it'll remain 2-1. 20 minutes to go here at the Prince William Ice Center. Davis Stearns with Brian Schrems. Seeing some intense action and a different game compared to last night.
Yep.
Definitely a different game.
Yep. 40 minutes they've played so far. Last night they kind of fell apart there halfway through the second period, but this game is still within reach. Absolutely still within reach.
Everybody's had their piece of the pie in this game. We can't really highlight one single player, but if you were to highlight one single player, who would it be? And don't cheat and say the goaltender, Mr. Anderson.
No, Anderson's played a good game. You put me on the spot. You could tell they were missing something yesterday. Oh,
yeah.
They were missing a lot yesterday. But I think Egan is the one who they keep going back to time and time again. He's got the power play goal. He's got the size. We don't call Frankel's name a lot. He's been throwing his weight around a little bit here. And he's gotten significantly more ice time today than we've ever seen him have before. So there's obviously something that the coaches like. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's the size. Maybe it's the grit that he's putting down. But, you know, those are the two players. I like guys with size.
All right.
Especially with this team.
Going Egan and Frankel. You like the big rough and tumble guys.
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, sounds good. Let's take it into an intermission break, and we'll rejoin you here with the third period in a few moments' time. It's David Stearns, Brian Shrems, and Jason Wakely for Cross Ice Feed. Stay tuned. 20 more minutes to go as the Knights lead the Patriots 2-1. 2-1. Welcome back, everybody, to the Prince William Ice Center. David Stearns with Brian Shrems and Jason Wakely on the camera as we get set for a final 20 minutes of play as the Atlanta Knights lead the Potomac Patriots 2-1. No scoring in that period to talk about. Quite an exciting back-and-forth contest, and Anderson having to come up big in that last flurry of activity in his vicinity by the Atlanta Knights, but he keeps it a one-goal game.
It's been a pretty exciting contest so far. Shoot the puck is the old adage, and it continues to plague the Potomac Patriots.
Yeah.
15 shots on goal is not going to cut it if you want to come out with a victory today, but
yeah,
it's only a one-goal deficit. We've seen them much worse off, and it's certainly attainable. They've had the opportunities, six-man advantages so far. You know, not really the desired result.
Yeah.
One for six.
And, yeah. That's where they were last night.
Yeah.
At the finish.
But we'll see what happens. Third period.
Face-off won by the Knights over to the near side of Stallard. Stallard across the line. Over to the half-boards he goes. Being shadowed by Reynolds. Reynolds trying to squeeze him off the puck, but Stallard gets around him. Looking for Montagna that was breaking in the slot, but the puck's chipped away over to Miller. Miller trying to free it there. Montagna will find it, but it's kind of kicked in and pinched along the boards by Kyle Powers. Powers, of course, having an astounding game back in December, the last game that we called, the last two games that we called. One of them was an overtime win on a hat trick from him, so hoping that he might have a breakout game here this morning. Reynolds looking through center, trying to find Powers, but it's cut off by Trichet. Trichet trying to work his way around Reynolds, and Reynolds is going to get called for a hold or a hook. And it is a hold indeed, so shorthanded for the next 2 minutes, 19:15 left here in the third. Oh, boy. They have capitalized on one-man advantage, the Atlanta Knights, that is. Both teams getting one on the power play, but,
you know,
yeah, we'll see what happens here.
I like the aggressiveness of Reynolds. I like the aggressiveness of Rubin, but you have to keep that in check, especially in the third period of a game this close.
The Patriots go on the Reebok hockey penalty kill. Potomac penalty to number 77, Matt Reynolds. 2 minutes for holding. Time of the penalty, 45 seconds.
It's up top now for Massa over to the far circle, and a shot and a rebound left Juicy up front, but swept away by the Patriots, not out, kept in there by Fenton. Over to Massa, who tees up a shot, and it gets deflected wide. Credit Rubin on that one as he's trying to tie up his man, and I believe it went off of him. Rubin chasing it now back behind the goal, sending it around the horn, kept in by Massa along the far blue line. Massa over to the near side. Top of the circle, Dumon back up top to Massa at the top of the umbrella over to the far circle over to Fenton. Fenton walking in, looking back door with a shot and a save. Oh, baby, that one was loose after. But now the fists start coming up.
It seems to be the case with every stoppage of play that the goaltender creates.
Yeah. 18:32 left here in the third. 1:17 left on the penalty to Reynolds on the Reebok hockey penalty kill. Elliott will take the draw against Egan. Jeffrey Egan for the Patriots. And turning around, Rubin, Montagne, what are you doing? Marley keeping it in on the faceoff win. Over to Montagne along the half boards. Swept out by Rubin. He's caught up at the red line, back to his own blue line as Harley. Harley going with the pass over to Stallard. Stallard dropping it back there for Harley again as he was shadowed by Egan. Over to the near side boards and into the corner of the Patriots zone. Oh, and going down hard there is Stallard, who lost his footing. Oh, boy. That did not look good. Oh, he is slow to get up. I'm sure he's just a little shaken here. The point shot comes through. Anderson sees that one. And the rebound is cleared out down the length of the ice. Davis out there in the far corner. Moves it over to the near side. Nice pass over to McDonald. Stallard is slow to get over that bench. 17:45 left here in the third. 30 seconds left on the man advantage for Atlanta. Elliott gets crushed into the boards there.
Got away with one that could have been a boarding call.
Easily. Up top to the blue line, Harley looking for options here. Takes a shot and it just goes wide of the short side. Into the near side boards. McDonald looking. The pass down low over to Elliott. Elliott looking up front, looking for a deflection. It goes wide. And Anderson knocks the net off. It's Mooring. So 4 seconds left on the penalty to the Patriots. 17-19 left here in the third. Still a 2-1 Atlanta lead. Patriots hockey sponsored in part by Spine and Joint Institute, located in Fairfax on Old Lee Highway. Visit sjinstitute.com to book your appointment with Dr. Felix Yeskin and Dr. Maria Schaefer for your chiropractic and joint needs. Dugas taking a shot, gunning it wide as it's picked up along the far half boards by Micah DeBow. Pushed ahead there for Barber, who sends it down the length of the ice, but they're going to get tagged with an icing. So Barber will have to come back out onto the ice as he was halfway over. The faceoff will come down to the right of Anderson. 35-15, shots in favor of Atlanta. Patriots still have yet to find an opportunity to set up shop inside the Knights zone. You'll get that when you're shorthanded. Shot goes through all that traffic, and Anderson finds that as he goes down to the butterfly. This kind of got me in the mood for some pizza.
You buying?
Face-off one over to the half boards. McInnes keeping it in, but swept around over to the near side for Santiago. Santiago looking cross-ice. Oh, and he had a breaking Miller through center. And trying to hook up with Miller again was Powers. Powers put that pass in the air. Miller will find it, and he'll backhand it in. But it's caught up by McInnes. McInnes along the far side with the pass. Up ahead there for Ventura, but it's pushed away from him. Anderson's slowing it up there for Rubin. Rubin going to the far side. McInnes tapping it in there for a second, but Miller looking through center, trying to hook up Santiago, trying to handle that puck cleanly, was Benz. Benz losing control of it, though, as he had his pocket picked, and it's tapped back. And Ventura will have to recover it back in the near corner. Over to the far side, Keenan Fenton centering it there for Fiorillo. Fiorillo along the far side of the Patriots zone, looking for options here. So he takes his shot through and easily gloved down with a little bit of a flare the glove by Anderson.
That. Just make sure you got control of that flare and don't toss it into your net like Patrick Waugh does.
As Patrick Waugh, and I think Marty Brodeur has done it a time or two before.
No,
it was in the playoffs. Martin Brodeur did that. Did he not?
It's flashy. No,
that was Patrick Waugh. You're right.
It's flashy, but, you know.
But Brodeur has done it a time or two. And Fleury, too, yeah. Marc-Andre Fleury. See, goalies, they make mistakes.
They're human, too.
Yeah. See, we got a camera guy who's a goaltender, so he knows better than most, I guess. And, I mean, Anderson's first name is Patrick. I hope that doesn't jinx him or anything. Over to the near side, and Judd Parker trying to hook up on a pass there. It's deflected through. No icing. It's being chased down by Massa. Massa along the near side over to the Stallard. Stallard could not reach that pass. Kept in by Barber, trying to find Parker. But Massa will find it. Oh, no. Nick Rose will pick his pocket. Up front. Oh, and a shot by Barber just gone over the glove of Davis. Oh, man. That was an opportunity if I've ever seen one. Winnett keeping it out of his own zone. Gets a pass off the boards over to Parker. Parker coming across the Knights line, trying to shoot it through four bodies. Now Miller will come in there to support. And so will Egan up ahead for Miller. Miller taking a long toss on Davis, and he'll make the save. These long-distance shots, they don't do you a whole lot of good unless you got some bodies up front, but, hey, take the shots. You don't score on the shots you don't take.
That's true.
What is that Gretzky quote that everyone uses?
You miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Something like that. Yeah. I don't know. I don't do math.
Here comes a shot through traffic, and it was deflected on Davis, makes the save. Jeffrey Egan picking it up along the near corner. DeBow trying to get there first, but it's tapped along by Kim. Now DeBow will have another crack at it up front. Oh, and a chance for Miller. Looking for the one time. Kept in along the far blue line by Rubin. Down low, Egan trying to shovel it up to the front again to Miller, but this one will be played up ahead by Trichet. Trichet with a lead pass along the boards. Too far for McDonald. Picked up by Rubin along the near half boards, and DeBow put it up along the boards and out. Jeffrey Egan trying to pop that one ahead by the glove, but Kim will pull away with the puck, and he gets hauled down. No call.
How is that not a penalty?
Rubin got away with one there. He loses a stick in the process. Up top at the point, and Gibson trying to take that shot, but another try there by McDonald. Keeps it in off into the far corner. Lamar could not get there first. Rubin taking his man to the boards. Trichet Trichette moving it over to Kim. Kim still with it, being pressured and checked from behind by Egan, and Egan will sit for two or more. Now we got some pushing and shoving.
I can't see the man who's down.
I believe it was Ventura. So Jeffrey Egan will sit. And he is still down. Hopefully he is okay. And the doc will come out to see. I beg your pardon, that was Say Kim, not Ventura. So 13:59 left here in the third period. 2-1 Atlanta Knights. They're about to go on the Reebok hockey penalty kill. The Patriots are, and resulting in a Knights power play. Egan, the captain, will sit for two or more, dependent upon the call, and they're going to say boarding.
Knights made quick work of that power play they had in the first period.
Only 2 minutes. Okay. There we go. What's that?
I said they made quick work of that power play they had in the first period.
Oh, yes, they did. Yes, they did. Let's get the official call from Jared Ronski. Now at the timekeeper's box.
The Patriots go on the Reebok hockey penalty kill. Potomac penalty to number 76, Jeff Egan. 2 minutes for boarding.
Nope.
Time of the penalty, 6:01.
No goal on the call there, as they had plenty of Knights on top of Anderson.
Penalty?
Anderson. There was no chance.
Going goalie interference? It sounds like he's getting a penalty. Oh, and that's the end of it.
Well, yeah. The disbelief by Elliott. Yeah, they're going to throw, I believe, Fenton or Elliott into the box here. It looks like Elliott's going to go.
Or is it a face-off?
No, it's just a face-off outside. If you interfere with a goaltender and a goal goes in, how is it not a penalty?
I thought he was escorting him off, but
I know, Elliott
was my mistake.
He was dramatic about, the face-off's coming outside. Oh, man. Harley with the point shot. Finds its way through traffic, but deflected wide.
Is Wakely talking about the Flyers?
Yeah, he's talking about the Flyers
God.
Again.
That doesn't shut up about the Flyers.
That's all right. The Sabres, Flyers, and Capitals are all going to miss the playoffs. And a shot on to Anderson. I think Jason Wakely just put in his 2 weeks' notice.
I agree.
Oh, you agree? Good. Oh, man. Montagne leading it up top for Stallard. Stallard looking for a lane. Finds it back door. Shot off the side of the net. Elliott trying to bury it home.
It's a 48 shot for the Knights in the game.
And a shot 41. Right into the glove of Anderson, who holds on. Boy, he's seen a lot of work this morning. 13:08 left here in the third period. 1:09 left on Jeffrey Egan's boarding minor. Knights holding onto this 2-1 lead, and the Patriots trying to hang in there the best they can. It's hard to set up offense when you're on the penalty kill half the period so far. McDonald in the near circle takes a shot, pad saved by Anderson. Great movement to kick that one aside. It's kept in at the point by Dumont. Dumont gets a return pass up top through the traffic up front and gets deflected off from the far corner and chipped up to
That's
the blue
out.
Line.
Not, out.
Oh, that one was out. Yeah, I thought that one was in though. Pretty close.
I got it, linesman. Don't worry.
Okay. This one's saucered high into the glove of Davis. And he's going to opt to hold on as Judd Parker's right there in the blue paint waiting. 35 seconds left to kill and a faceoff coming up next to Davis.
They just need that. They need that one rebound to come out to them. They need that one just fluke instance to tie this game up and snag a point here today at least.
Just a reminder, after this game, immediately after, we have the EJHL South matchup between Atlanta and Potomac. So stay tuned. Got plenty of hockey for you. And, of course, we'll be back here in a couple weeks' time as the Hampton Roads Whalers come to town.
It's going to be a good weekend.
Also worth noting that next weekend these two teams will play each other in a four-game set down in Atlanta. So this one goes up into the lighting fixture above the ice.
What is Ronski up to today?
He's up to
Holy
Spice Girls. How about that?
Smokes, Ronski.
Hey, we saw the reunion at the Olympics this past summer. Come on.
I switched the channel for that, actually.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah. I brought it back from Mr. Bean, though. That was funny.
Not a fan of Ginger Spice, Scary Spice, and all right, I'll stop.
Wow.
Stallard on the far circle, looking for a lane to take a shot, but he passes it over to Hartley, who shoots it off the side of the net. Montagne picking up along the far half boards. Montagne back up top of the umbrella. Stallard back down over to Harley. Harley looking, taking a shot right into Fenton up front, and then Anderson will reach out and hold on to it. I hope Fenton's okay. That's all I'm going to say. That shot was pretty precise.
Reminds me of a shot you took a couple weeks ago in Reisterstown.
Oh, man. So I was up on the scaffolding at Reisterstown, and boy, did I get clocked with the one that came out of play. Oh, boy. The bruise is just going away, and let's just say that everything's okay. Everything's still intact. This one finds its way to the front of the net, and Anderson holds on. 12 minutes even left here in the third. 1 second left on Egan's penalty. 2-1 Atlanta. Patriots being outshot 44-16. Oh, my goodness.
And they're only down by one.
Anderson is definitely keeping them in this one.
Oh.
Wow, lucky bounce deflecting out of the play brings Egan back out of the penalty box. So we're back to five-a-side hockey as three ticks come off the clock. Face-off won by the Knights. Up top to Benz. Benz along the half boards. Finds it over to Eliash. Eliash all the way around over to the far corner, and working his way in there is McInnes. He clears it over to the near side boards, trying to find Zachary Egan. And now Powers, trying to power his way through center with the puck, and Benz will find it, trying to clear it in deep into the Patriots zone, but it's caught up by Dugas. Dugas will put it into the far corner. Rubin will get there first. Over to the near side corner, over to Winnett. Winnett up along the boards and cleared down the ice and deflected through, so no icing. Benz deflected it through. Parker gets there first regardless. Parker looking for some help. Frankel back there, but it's cleared all the way around over to the far blue line. Kept in by Rubin. Here's Parker with a shot, and he couldn't get a full wrap on it. Along the near side boards and out. The Knights will tip it out with Eliash. Winnett picking up back at his own blue line. Going D-to-D over to Rubin. Back over to Winnett. Winnett through center. Winds up. Clears it in. No icing. So it goes all the way around the horn. Nick Gross trying to find it. But it's out of his area as it gets pushed ahead. Ventura clearing it up for McDonald. But McDonald could not get there in time as the Patriots will clear it up through center. Now Barber coming across the Knights line with a shot right into the glove of Davis. And he'll hold on with the faceoff coming. 10:42 left here in the third. 2-1 Knights. David Stearns with Brian Shrems and Jason Wakely. We are your Cross Ice Feed broadcasting team. Check us out at crossicefeed.com. And also, if you miss any of today's action or any action that we broadcast, check out our YouTube page. Look us up, Cross Ice Feed, one word, or click on the archive button on our main page. You can also follow us on Twitter at Cross Ice Feed and like us on Facebook as well. Along the near side and cleared out into the neutral zone. Lamar trying to pop it back the other way, but Ventura getting ahead of, I believe that's Welsh, but he'll go into the boards with Welsh. The puck is found by Ferrillo. Ferrillo putting it to the front, and Anderson making yet another save. His 44th save of the game thus far. 45-16 in shots. Shrems, this is where's the offense?
Yeah, no, it's and the game's close. That's what we have to keep reiterating. The game is close at this point. One shot could be the difference maker in a point versus no point weekend.
Speaking of one shot, they only have one this period.
Yeah, no, yeah. You're right. You're spot on, sir.
Because I wouldn't count any of the ones that come from the red line right into Davis's glove.
Which have been quite a few so far.
Yes, yes. And DeBow coming across the line, feeding it to the front, but it gets deflected wide. Miller shoveling it over to Egan, but it was just deflected on its way through. Kim along the far side of the neutral zone and in with a drop pass there, trying to hook up with Massa, and the Patriots will clear it down the length of the ice. And this one
will not. Oh, I disagree.
Yeah, I do too. Miller had the extra step as he got around Dumond, but they're going to rule that one an icing with 9:36 to go here in the third.
Man, what do they have to do here? What has to be done? I mean, you pull your goaltender, yes, obviously, gives you the extra attacker, but...
Yeah. Change up the lines, maybe? What was a shot through in the way of that one was Montagne. Montagne limping around a little bit, but now he's skating fine. He has the puck off on the near side. Turning around, taking a shot. Patrick Anderson will put that along the glass, and that one squirts up into the front and cleared away by the Patriots. This one will not make it far enough for icing, so we'll get those much-needed changes out there on the ice. 9-10 remains in the third.
No,
and
not.
No, they're going to say that one deflected through, so no icing. This one comes around the horn over to the near side board. Santiago couldn't get there as it was deflected back over to Reynolds. Reynolds over to Rubin along the far side and moving up through neutral. Powers trying to get there first, trying to get around Harley. Harley trapped it up there just for a second. Nick Gross, though, loosens it up, but Stallard will pick it up and send it through center. Picked up at the blue line by Rubin. Up ahead for Powers, and he was tangled up at the moment, so it comes around over to Harley. Harley with a pass over to McDonald. McDonald could not get that pass as he was tied up by Nick Gross. Nick Gross taking down his man. Ooh, he got away with one there.
Pitchers have been quite fortunate this period.
Yes, they have. And Reynolds trying to kick it ahead for himself, but it's kept in by the Knights. Oh, no, nice work there by Kyle Powers. Reynolds trying to split the D and move the puck ahead, but Harley will pick it up. Harley coming back the other way. He create a 3-on-2, but Santiago's in there. Nice save up front. That one sticked out of the air. I believe that one hit Anderson in the mask, but it just went wide. 8:15 left here in the third, 2-1 Knights. Harley up top at the point with a shot that gets deflected wide. And a backhand through to the front, misses everybody. McDonald trying to set up someone in the slot, but Gibson will keep it in, putting it deep into the near corner for Ventura. Ventura getting tangled up there with Rubin and Reynolds, but the puck is set free by Fiorillo. And it'll be cleared up ahead by Santiago with the pass over to Miller. Miller working with Powers. Powers going towards the net, but Miller's shot did not get past McInnes, who was in the way of that one. McDonald leading it ahead now for McInnes. McInnes coming in 1-on-2. Winds up, takes a shot, and Anderson makes the save. McInnes going into the boards with Welsh, and Kyle Powers trying to sweep it free. And it is kicked free finally, but it'll be the Knights that are victors on that one. Sage Dugas trying to go for it. Dugas tied up with Welsh. Cleared around to the boards, not out, kept in by McInnes up at the point, trying to take a shot through Miller, but Miller got in the way of that one. Powers dumping down his man. Taking out Zachary Egan. Egan, though, will put the pass up top for McInnes, who sets it up for Eliash on the slot, who takes a shot. Nice work there by Lamar, who got into the play
just in the
nick of time. And, yeah, he got crushed. Just touching that puck. Oh, you're going to get punished. And now here comes a chance. Oh, what a great glove save by Anderson. Oh, baby. Hot leather.
That's 47.
Whew. 7 minutes left here in the third period. Anderson keeping his team in this one as they are down 2-1. 47-16 in shots. What a margin. Stay tuned after this game. EJHL South action immediately to follow as Atlanta takes out Potomac. Parker. Along the near side, trying to drag his shot through, but Massa got in the way of that one, deflecting it off into the far corner. Barber trying to move it up ahead there for Gross. It was just behind him, but the Knights will find it and bring it out into the neutral zone. The Knights are currently offsides, and they will get tagged with 6:40 left in the third. It is Mambo number 5.
I don't have anything to say. I'm at a loss for words.
And it goes back. The face-off win by the Patriots. Reynolds working with Winnett. And Reynolds putting it through center. Turned over.
Turnovers.
And Trichet trying to gun home. A goal here as he tried to break it on Anderson, but it was cut off by Reynolds. This one floats all the way down to Davis. Comes up along the near side for Trichet. Trichet trying to move the pass along past Winnett. Winnett, nice work there as he blocks it from going into his own zone. And he puts it deep inside Knights territory. Almost 6 minutes left here in the third period. 2-1 Atlanta. This one goes high into the glass and into the steel beam above the Knights bench. 6:06 to be exact left here in the third.
Trichet McDonald with the goals for Atlanta. Egan with the goal on the power play for the Potomac Patriots. They are 1-for-7 on the day with the man advantage.
One to the front there. DeBow trying to get a hold of it. Stallard bounced it off his shoulder and he'll get a return pass there from Harley. Harley leading the charge back along the near side boards. Oh, and he draws his team off sides. So 5:55 left here in the third. Atlanta still with the one goal lead.
There's been no sense of urgency. It's just damage control in the defensive end. Just get the puck out, change, get the puck out, change. There's no quality rushes taking place right now.
Well, they need to create something soon, that's for sure, because they're running out of time. Definitely want to tie this one up. And
at least give Anderson a tie here. I mean, he deserves that much.
And it's led to the front. Anderson finds it. And it's underneath them. No, it's loose. They score! Bounced off his pad as it was squeezed between pad and post. And inside the net was Noah Rubin trying to keep it out. But just like that, it's 3-1 Atlanta on the 49th shot by the Knights. definitely can't fault Anderson on that one. No. Too much going on along the side of the net as he tried to maintain his position. He was bumped around a few times, and eventually somehow Ruben ended up in the net, and so did the puck.
I wonder if Fiorillo got it.
He may have.
Can't really tell. I know he was down there poking around, but no, unfortunate for Anderson. You know, just the rebound got away from him.
Goal, scoring his seventh goal of the season, number 12, Austin Ventura. Assisted by number 15, Patrick McDonald. And by number 5, Rick Fiorillo. Time of the goal, 14:25.
So Fiorillo creating that play. There, of course, on the second assist, trying to set a break pass there for Santiago, but the Knights are offside as came back into the zone. 5:12 left here in the third, 3-1 Knights.
You know, you had to figure it was only a matter of time. I mean, the Patriots have only amassed one shot this period, and that is not going to it's not going to tie a game for you when you need it most.
Definitely not. Santiago along the near side boards, and it seems like, you know, what is it that Atlanta's doing that the Patriots can't seem to break down? I mean, it's not like they're running the trap or anything, are they?
Nope.
Well, they might be.
Yes, hip check.
Hip check there by Reynolds on Benz. Benz gave him a little tap after. Now the Patriots can't break out of their own zone. They're looking for an offensive rush, but it seems very undisciplined right now in how they're trying to exit the zone. No? They just chip it out into the neutral zone and don't pursue it much further after that. So here's Reynolds. Reynolds going to try to do it himself here. He does deke out two. Still with it, creating a 3-on-2. Taking a shot, it's deflected out of the protective netting. Well, at least they'll get the faceoff inside the zone. 4:20 left here in the third. 3-1 Atlanta. 49-16 shots. Patrick Anderson seeing plenty of shots today, and he has had plenty of beautiful saves. Just got to get the supporting cast around him to maybe tie this one up. And I'm very superstitious, so I blame you. Once you say at least get him the tie, what happened?
Immediately. It happened immediately.
Yeah. And now working with it. Along the short side, trying to backhand it in. It was Dugas. Dugas still working at it. It's chipped free over to the far side. And the Patriots with Miller. Miller can't get around his man. It's chipped in by Eliash. Eliash putting it deep there into the Patriots zone. Ruben will go along the near side to Welsh. Welsh having trouble here. Welsh and Dugas tied up in the corner. Dugas trying to kill some time here as we have 3:38 left here in the third. 50 shots to 60. And they are refusing to move it, and finally we'll get a whistle. I guess we're going to let another minute go before we did something about that. 11:50 will be the start time for this morning's EJHL South matchup that will immediately follow this one. 3:29 left in this contest, 3-1 Atlanta. I mean, this third period really, really kept moving along, but then there was the offsides, the offsides, the offsides, the offsides. Potomac will call their timeout, and Coach Little and Sherman will try to rally the troops and get them focused here. It looks like a really short bench over there.
No, it does. It does. I mean, compared to what Atlanta has, it's noticeably shorter. But
yeah,
we can't say that they've been outplayed today. They've been outshot. No doubt about
that. They've been outshot.
But you know, Potomac has held their own. It's been a close game, and up until the last couple minutes here, it's been a decent back and forth action. But again, the lack of shots is gonna run its course, and this is the result that you get.
Certainly is.
But now 3:29 left to go here in the third period. Time is running a little bit thin. 50 shots, and you know, Anderson should get a cap tip for at least the second or third star of the game.
Well, most certainly, and you know, Davis has held his own, and you know, only allowing one goal on 16 shots, so I don't think he's been tested enough.
No, heavens no.
Yeah.
And the shots that he has gotten have been perimeter shots. I mean, no screen in front.
And all the credit in the world to the defense of Atlanta. I mean, defenders like Massa and Harley, Gibson and Benz,
good accountability. They are back there.
Yep.
Back checking, hustling. Forwards too, getting back, helping out. They got a pretty good unit down there in Atlanta.
And that's why they are the number one team. Well, the number two team. Now they're pushing to be tied as the number one team if they take the victory in this one. All dependent upon how the Florida Junior Blades are doing. But they certainly do have a first place caliber team here. Reynolds putting it up along the glass and all the way deep down to Davis. Davis kicking it there over for Dumai. The pass back for Massa. And now we're going to have a delayed call made on a trip against the Atlanta Knights. A very timely power play. 3:07 left here in the third.
There's ever an opportunity to take advantage of. This would be right the one
now.
Right now.
Yes.
I always say the eighth time is the charm. This is when I talk to my kids at school. Eighth time is the charm, kids. Keep at it.
The kids that you teach, you don't have kids, right?
Oh, God, no.
Atlanta penalty to number 24, Ryan Dumont. 2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty, 16:53.
Exactly 3 minutes left here in the third. 1:49 left on the penalty. The Metro DC DJs power play. Visit them at MetroDCDJs.com to book them for your wedding or any other celebration you may be having. It's really big on the weddings. It really is. Not so much conferences. Nobody likes playing techno music at conferences.
Could be a new market to open up, though.
Hey, there we go. We'll make it more fun.
Side gig?
Who likes to go to a conference anyway? Well, I can think of reasons. Along the near side, up ahead for Barber. It's open bar. That's a secret.
Oh.
Back down low, Davis. Setting it up along the half boards and clear it up. Here comes a breakaway chance for Stallard, but it's out of his reach, and Reynolds is going to rush to get back. Reynolds looking to cut it off. And Anderson could not reach back in time. He had the initial glove save, but it bounced over his glove and in. It's 4-1 Atlanta on a shorthanded goal. 2:05 left here in the third period. Atlanta cushioning their lead.
That's a shame for Anderson. That was a gorgeous glove save that just got away from him. Mm. This one's going to... Yeah, tough loss again for the Atlanta or for the Potomac Patriots at the hands of the Atlanta Knights.
Shorthanded goal, scoring his 20th goal of the season, number 28, Cole Stallard. Assisted by number 22, James Eliash. Time of the goal, 17:55.
And don't forget, next weekend, these guys will see each other once again down in Atlanta. Actually, twice again down in Atlanta. So... You know, the difference between the 8-3 and then the potential 4-1 loss here, maybe 4-2 if they can get one here on the power play, a vast difference between last night and this morning.
Yep.
So, Nicky Gross stepping in, trying to take a shot through Massa. Massa got in the way of that one. Egan backhanding it around over to the far side to Winnett. He's got Ruben up top here at the point. Now Egan's going to opt to go over to the near side. Finding it up top over Nicky Gross. No, it goes out of his reach over to Ruben. Ruben trying to give it over to Gross, but instead it'll be played ahead. And a hard check there on Massa, or by Ruben, is cleared down the length of the ice. Five-a-side hockey as we go down to our final minute here in the third period. 4-1 Atlanta. Sent up high into the air, looking through center, trying to hook up with Miller. Miller had the pass behind him, tried to control it on his way in, but he lost control of it in the process. Up ahead now through neutral, and it's tapped in. And a nice hard check there by Ruben on Zachary Egan. Anderson settling it up here along the near side over for DeBow. DeBow could not handle the pass. Ventura trying to take his shot through, but gets deflected off into the far corner. Elias trying to settle it down there with Egan. We have 30 seconds left here in the third. Pass over and out. Harley almost drew his team in on the offside to get another stoppage, but please, let's just let this run one run its course. No more stoppages, will you? Ventura along the half boards, down to the corner, trying to move it along the goal line to a feed to the front, but instead it's stopped up. Mike DeBell can take it back the other way with 10 seconds remaining here. John Davis will let this one go by. Miller finding it in the far corner, taps it behind the net, and that'll do it. The Atlanta Knights are victorious in this one, 4-1. We'll get our Metro DC DJs 3 stars and close out the broadcast as we get set for some EJHL South action on the other side.
Yeah. Third period, shots on goal for Atlanta, 19 for a game total of 51. For Potomac, 1 for a game total of 16. Ladies and gentlemen, here are today's Metro DC DJs, three stars of the game. First, the number 3 star from Atlanta with a goal and an assist, number 15, Patrick McDonald. Yeah. The number 2 star from Atlanta also with a goal and an assist, number 28, Cole Stallard. And the number 1 star from Potomac with 47 saves, number 70, Patrick Anderson.
Well deserved. Patrick Anderson, the number 1 star of the game, 47 saves. Man, did he see a lot of shots. He might need to get some new pads. Those things have got to be marked up. Maybe even a new jersey, too. Yep. Well, a loss and a loss, but hopefully they'll find a win next weekend down in Atlanta. So we'll cut it off here, folks, on the Empire side of things, and we'll rejoin you with the EJHL South side of things in just a few moments' time. It's David Stearns, Brian Schrems, and Jason Wakely saying have a good afternoon, everybody. Stay tuned for the next game coming up here between Atlanta and Potomac. As the Empire game concludes, Atlanta victorious over the Potomac Patriots with a final score of 4-1. Don't stop believing.